Good morning, everyone. Welcome to today's Resurrection Sunday service.
大家好，今天是复活的主日。
I'd like to make an announcement in Cantonese for the Cantonese speaking translations.
我现在先用广东话做一个报告。
如果你只是听广东话，麻烦你举手，我们有个耳机给你。 有没有人举手？ 需要耳机。 And also, as a reminder, I'd like to ask that you silence your cell phones and any device that you have.
另外也提醒大家，请你们将你们的手机放成静音的模式。
Let's take a moment to quiet our heart in preparation for today's worship. So please meditate on this scripture.
我们先安静我们的心，来预备我们的心敬拜。
Let's all rise.
我们请大家起立。
And sing hymn 133, Thy is the glory.
我们唱诗133首，复活得胜主。
Next hymn is Amazing Grace. He indeed is amazing.
我们再唱一首诗歌，奇异恩典。
We will have the choir presentations.
And
after the choir, the children are dismissed to their worship program. And after the choir also, we will turn the time to Pastor Elton.
现在诗班献诗了以后，孩子们就可以到他们的儿童的崇拜区，然后时间再交给朱碧涵牧师。
Wow. And all God's people said, amen.
Amen.
Amen. We thank the Lord for giving us this opportunity to worship him on Resurrection Sunday.
And
today, my message, the topic of my message will be, why did Jesus have to rise from the dead?
今天我信息的题目是为何耶稣必要从死里复活?
And our passage will be taken from the book of John, chapter 20, verses 8 and 9.
我们的, 圣经的经节是约翰福音20章8到9节。
These verses describe the response of Jesus' disciples, John and Peter, as they saw the resurrection of Jesus.
这是约翰 和彼得,当他们看到耶稣的复活以后,
In John chapter 20, verses 8 and 9, it says, Finally, the other disciple who had reached the tomb first also went inside. He saw and believed. They still did not understand from Scripture that Jesus had to rise from the dead.
约翰福音20章8到9节 先到坟墓的那门徒也进去,看见就信了,因为他们还不明白圣经的意思,就是耶稣必要从死里复活。
In the New American Standard, they did not understand that Jesus must rise from the dead.
从新美国标准版里面讲说,这里说耶稣必定要从死里复活。
Let's pray.
我们一起祷告。
Our dear Lord Jesus, as we come to worship you this morning, we remember not only your death on the cross for our sins.
亲爱的天父,我们今天早上,我们来到这里来敬拜的时候,我们不仅是纪念到主耶稣基督为我们的罪死在十字架上,
but we remember your resurrection from the dead.
但是我们也纪念
You are our living Savior and Lord.
And
Lord, I pray that the Holy Spirit would use your word to draw us to you.
May
your word speak to us. That you would be glorified. In Jesus' name we pray. Amen.
Amen.
We're here today on Resurrection Sunday to not only remember the death of our Lord and Savior Jesus Christ, but particularly to celebrate his resurrection. Jesus is the Lamb of God who came to die for our sins.
耶稣是神的羔羊, 他来到世上,
he died, he was buried, but he rose again on the third day according to the scriptures.
照圣经所说, 他死了, 埋葬了,
I remember a past conversation that I had with an attorney about the resurrection of Christ.
我记得有一次我跟一位律师跟他谈论关于复活的事。
This attorney said that he believed that Jesus died on the cross for our sins, but that he could not accept the resurrection.
这位律师说,他相信耶稣为我们的罪死在十字架上,但他无法接受复活。
And he asked me if it was necessary to also believe the resurrection of Jesus in order to be saved.
所以他就问我是否有必要也要相信耶稣的复活才能得救。
And the answer I gave him was yes.
我给他答案是是的，当然。
And I gave him a number of reasons.
我给了他一些理由。
And a couple of the reasons I gave him were this.
我给他的一些理由是如此。
First of all,
第一个
the resurrection is of first importance.
因为复活这是首要的，是第一的。
In 1 Corinthians 15, 3 to 4, it says, For what I received, I passed on to you as of first importance, that Christ died for our sins, according to the scriptures, that he was buried, that he was raised on the third day, according to the scriptures.
哥林多前书十五章三到四节，我当日所领受又传给你们的，第一就是基督照圣经所说为我们的罪死了，而且埋葬了，又照圣经所说第三天复活了。
I also told him that the Bible also tells us that we need to believe this in Romans chapter 10 verse 9.
那之后我告诉他，圣经告诉我们说，我们需要相信。因为是在罗马书十章九节里面告诉我们
that if you confess with your mouth Jesus is Lord and believe in your heart that God raised him from the dead, you will be saved.
你若口里认耶稣为主，心里信神叫他从死里复活，就必得救。
Over the past 2,000 years, people have tried to disprove the resurrection of Jesus Christ.
在过去的两千年，人们试图要否认。
Because they knew that the resurrection is so woven into the fabric of Christianity that if you were to disprove it, it would leave you with virtually nothing.
因为他们知道复活已经牢牢地植入基督教的结构之中，若能够否认基督的复活，就可以使得基督教荡然无存。
The resurrection is at the very heart of Christianity.
复活是基督教的核心。
But no one has been able to disprove it.
但没有人能够否认基督的复活。
And as a matter of fact, many of the people who set out to disprove the resurrection and to try to destroy Christianity,
事实上，有许多人一开始的时候，他们要否认基督的复活，他们要摧毁基督教。
They ended up believing the resurrection and receiving Jesus themselves.
但最后反而相信复活，他们自己也接受了耶稣。
As well as writing books in defense of the resurrection and the Christian faith.
还写书来为复活和基督徒的信仰辩护。
Here are a few resources or books that if you are interested, you can look up yourselves.
这是有一些书，你们可以有兴趣要看的话，你们可以去读。
The authors were men who set out to disprove the resurrection.
然后这些作者呢，他们一共开始的时候，他们决定是要去否认基督的复活。
To try to destroy Christianity.
要摧毁基督教。
But they ended up receiving Christ.
但最后他们接受了基督。
And writing books in defense of the resurrection of Jesus.
然后最后还写书来为基督的复活辩护。
One book is by Josh McDowell, Evidence That Demands a Verdict.
一本书是麦道卫的《铁证待判》。
After he became a Christian, he has authored or co-authored over 150 Christian books.
他信主了以后，他跟也是跟其他人还有他自己写了150本书。
Another one is written by Frank Morrison, who was a journalist, and the name of the book was "Who Moved the Stone."
另外一位是新闻记者莫里逊，他写了一本书《莫石》。牧师悬疑悬谜。
Another resource was by Gilbert West, who was an English poet and an attorney, and the title of his book was Observations on the History and Evidences of the Resurrection of Jesus Christ.
另外一位是英国的诗人，和律师，他写了叫 Gilbert West, 他写了一本书《耶稣基督复活的观察》。
So the resurrection sets Christianity apart from all the world religions.
复活使得基督教和其他世界的宗教分别出来。
No world religion has a resurrection.
没有一个世界宗教他们有复活。
So whether or not the resurrection is true is not even an issue any longer.
所以复活是否是真实的，已经不是在是一个争议的问题了。
It's an undeniable historical fact.
是个无法否认的历史事实。
And any arguments against it are so absurd that it takes more faith to believe the explanations against the resurrection than to believe that the resurrection did indeed occur.
任何对复活持反对的理由都是荒谬的，与相信复活是真的发生相比，你需要有更大的信心来相信这些反对复活的解释。
A few of these arguments against the resurrection, one is the swoon theory.
有一些关于对复活的争论，有一个理论呢是晕厥理论。
And the argument is that Jesus never really died, he just fainted.
他们这争论的是说耶稣他没有死他只是昏倒了
But that's ridiculous
那是很不可思议的
His back and body were ripped to shreds from the flogging
他的后背皮开肉绽撕成碎片
He had holes in his wrists and feet from rusted spikes
他的肋旁有枪伤然后他的脚上有生锈的铁钉打入。
But most importantly, the Bible tells us that a soldier plunged a spear into his side and outflowed blood and water as evidence of death.
可是他圣经告诉我们，之后兵丁他们用一把枪刺入他的肋旁，然后之后有血跟水流出来，这就是证明。
Another argument was that the disciples stole the body.
另外一个争论是说，门徒把耶稣的尸首偷走了。
But that also doesn't make sense.
那这个实在没有道理的。
Because the Bible tells us that the disciples were scared; they were hiding.
那时候圣经告诉我们，当时候门徒们非常的害怕，他们躲起来了。
And the Bible also tells us that a Roman guard consisting of 8 to 12 Roman soldiers were sent to guard the tomb.
而且圣经告诉我们，罗马的守卫他们被差到要在这个墓的门前面，他们去要看守这个墓。
There's no way that these scared disciples could have fought off a trained Roman guard.
这是不可能，以非常害怕的这些门徒，他们可以击退了训练有素的罗马守卫。
Another argument was that the disciples went to the wrong tomb.
另外他们争论的是说，这些门徒们他们去错了坟墓。
But then the Jewish leaders who hated Jesus would have gone to the correct tomb, produced the body, and it would have been case closed.
那些恨耶稣的犹太领袖，只要把耶稣的尸体呈现出来，就可以结案了。
So this morning, we are not here to try to prove that the resurrection occurred.
所以今天早上我们不是要证明复活的确发生过。
But to show why the resurrection is so important.
而是要指出为什么复活是如此的重要。
And to look at the question, why did Jesus have to rise from the dead?
然后一起来思想这个问题，为什么耶稣必要从死里复活
？And I'm just going to quickly go through 5 reasons.
我就很快的要来讲五个原因。
Although there are more reasons than this.
当然，我们有更多的理由原因。
The first reason was in order to fulfill Scripture.
第一个理由是。它应验了圣经所说的。
The resurrection confirms that God's word, including the words of Jesus, are true and they can be trusted.
复活认证了神的话语，也包括了耶稣所说的。
We read
是真实的，是可信靠的。
We read the verse in John chapter 20, verse 9, which says they still did not understand from Scripture that Jesus had to rise from the dead.
我们刚刚读约翰福音20:9，因为他们还不明白圣经的意思，就是耶稣必要从死里复活。
They did not Peter and John did not understand before they actually saw the resurrection, but they later did after they saw that Jesus had risen.
彼得和约翰他们在看到复活的耶稣之前，他们就不明白，可之后他们看到了。
So what is an example from Scripture that Peter and John did not understand?
所以是什么是彼得和约翰所不明白耶稣必要从死里复活的圣经例子呢
？And one example that we see is from the Old Testament in Psalm chapter 16, verses 8 to 10.
一个例子是诗篇十六篇八到十节。
Although this psalm was written by David,
虽然这个诗篇是大卫所写的。
It was written under the inspiration of the Holy Spirit.
是圣灵启示他所写出来的。
So that the words that we see here in Psalm 16, 8 to 10 are actually the words of Jesus speaking to God the Father.
所以他诗篇十六篇八到十节，其实就是耶稣对父神所说的。
And David wrote this psalm about 1,000 years before Jesus was crucified.
当大卫写这个诗篇的时候，是在耶稣被钉十字架的1,000年以前。
I want to emphasize especially verse 10.
我要强调的特别是第十节。
It says, "I have set the Lord always before me."Because he is at my right hand, I will not be shaken. Therefore, my heart is glad and my tongue rejoices. My body also will rest secure. Because you will not abandon me to the grave, nor will you let your Holy One see decay.
我将耶和华常摆在我面前。因他在我右边，我必不致摇动。因此，我的心欢喜，我的灵快乐，我的肉身也要安然居住。因为你必不将我的灵魂撇在阴间，也不将你的圣者见朽坏。
And the Apostle Paul in Acts 13 and Peter in Acts chapter 2 confirm that this prophecy here, written by David, was actually referring to Jesus and not to David.
使徒行传十三章的使徒保罗和使徒行传第二章里面的彼得确认大卫所写的预言确实是讲到耶稣而不是大卫。
Because David was buried with his fathers and his body did decay.
因为大卫已经与他的列祖同埋而且他的身体也朽坏了。
Let's look at what Paul says in Acts 13. We'll look at verse 35 to 37.
我们先来看保罗在《使徒行传》十三章所写的，特别是35到37节。
Paul says, "So it is stated elsewhere," and he's quoting this prophecy in Psalm 16. "So it is stated elsewhere, you will not let your Holy One see decay. For when David had served God's purpose in his own generation, he fell asleep. He was buried with his fathers, and his body decayed."But the one whom God raised from the dead did not see decay.
三十五节又有一篇上说是讲到诗篇第十六篇，你必不叫你的圣者见朽坏。大卫在世的时候遵行了神的旨意，就睡了，归到他祖宗那里，已见朽坏。唯独神所复活的，他并未见朽坏。
对不起。And we see also in Acts chapter 2.31 to 32, that Peter also referred back to the prophecy in Psalm 16.
在《使徒行传》二章三十一到三十二节，我们看到彼得他也回去讲到诗篇第十六篇。
He says, "Seeing what was ahead," this means David, seeing what was ahead, he spoke of the resurrection of the Christ, that he was not abandoned to the grave, nor did his body see decay.God has raised this Jesus to life, and we are all witnesses of the fact.
所以他这三十一节讲到大卫，他预先看明这事，讲论基督复活说，他的灵魂不撇在阴间，他的肉身也不见朽坏。这耶稣神已经叫他复活了，我们都为这事做见证。
And Paul and Peter, as well as other apostles, were eyewitnesses to the resurrection.
保罗、彼得和其他的使徒们都是复活的见证人。
In a court of law, one of the most powerful testimonies is from eyewitnesses.
在法庭上最强有力的见证就是目击者的证言。
And this is what I brought up to this attorney that I was speaking to.
所以这是在我跟那位律师在讲的时候，我们所谈论的。
And he absolutely agreed with that.
他完全的同意我所说的。
And in 1 Corinthians chapter 15, looking at verse 5 and 6.
哥林多前书十五章，我们看五节到六节。
And he says, and that Jesus, he, appeared to Peter and then to the 12. After that, he appeared to more than 500 of the brothers at the same time, most of whom are still living, though some have fallen asleep.
第五节就是耶稣，然后是讲到耶稣，并且显给基法看，然后显给十二使徒看，后来一时显给五百多弟兄看，其中一半一大半到如今还在，却也有已经睡了的。
We see in verse 6 that Paul told the people in the Corinthian church that there were over 500 other witnesses of the resurrection of Jesus.
在哥林多前书十五章第六节里面，保罗对哥林多教会的人说，有五百多见证人。
And in other words, if you, and he says, most of whom are still living.
其中一大半那时候还在。
So in other words, if you don't believe that Jesus rose from the dead, here are all these living witnesses. Go ahead and cross-examine each one of them.
换句话说，他就说，你还不相信耶稣已经从死里复活了吗？这些都是活生生的见证人，你可以去盘问他们呢。
Additionally, in a number of Bible verses, we have Jesus, the Word of God, come in the flesh, prophesying about his own resurrection.
另外，从其他的很多经节里面，我们看到道成肉身的耶稣自己预言他的复活。
And Jesus knew exactly what would happen to him.
耶稣他完全的确实知道在他身上将会发生什么事。
In Matthew 17:23, Jesus says they will kill him, and on the third day he will be raised to life. And the disciples were filled with grief.
马太福音十七章二十三节，耶稣他说，他们将要杀害他，第三日他要复活，门徒就大大的忧愁。
And then in Matthew 20 verse 19, Jesus says, and will turn him over to the Gentiles to be mocked and flogged and crucified. On the third day, he will be raised to life.
马太福音二十章十九节，耶稣他说，又交给外邦人，将他戏弄、鞭打、钉在十字架上，第三日他要复活。
So the point of all this that I have shared is that the truthfulness of Scripture and all the words of Jesus are at stake here.
所以我们从这些经节看到这一切的重点，让我们看到圣经的可靠性和所有耶稣所说的都在面临严峻的考验。
If the resurrection did not occur,
如果复活没有发生，
all the prophecies in the Old Testament about the resurrection of Jesus are wrong.
所有在旧约圣经里关于基督的复活的预言都是错误的。
What Jesus said about himself regarding his resurrection is wrong.
耶稣所有所说的关于他自己的复活都是错误的。
What all the apostles said about Christ being raised is wrong.
使徒们所说关于耶稣的复活都是错误的。
And if that is the case,
如果真是如此，
you cannot trust the Bible anymore.
你就不能够再相信圣经了。
Furthermore, you cannot trust Christ anymore.
而且你不能够再相信基督了。
And this is why people who try to destroy Christianity try to disprove the resurrection.
所以说，这是这么多年来许许多多的人，他们要尽量的，他们要否认耶稣的复活，否认圣经。
Because if you can disprove the resurrection, the scripture is basically ripped to shreds.
所以说，你能够否认耶稣的复活的话，圣经就完全的粉碎了。
But if the resurrection did occur according to the scriptures.
可是照圣经所说，复活的确发生了。
Then the Bible, including its prophecies and all the words of Jesus, can be trusted.
所以圣经所有的预言，也包括耶稣所说的一切话，都是可信靠的。
Including what Jesus said about himself in John 14:6, I am the way and the truth and the life. No one comes to the Father except through me.
然后也证实了耶稣所在约翰福音十四章六节所说的，耶稣说：“我就是道路、真理、生命，若不借着我，没有人能到父那里去。”
So remember 1 Corinthians 15.
所以我们还记得哥林多前书十五章
that Christ died for our sins according to the scriptures, that he was buried, that he was raised on the third day according to the scriptures.
第一就是基督照圣经所说为我们的罪死了，而且埋葬了，又照圣经所说第三天复活了。
So Christ had to rise from the dead in order to fulfill scripture.
所以耶稣必要从死里复活来应验圣经所说的。
And his resurrection confirms that God's word is true and that it can be trusted.
基督复活也确认了神的话语的真实，是真实的，是可信靠的。
And that Jesus can be trusted.
所以我们可以信靠耶稣。
Another reason, so why did Jesus have to rise from the dead?
为何耶稣必要从死里复活呢？
In order to confirm the deity of Christ.
第二个原因是确认基督的神性。
The resurrection of Christ is the greatest proof of him being God.
基督的复活是对他耶稣基督是神是最好的证明。
Jesus is 100% God and 100% man at the same time.
基督同时他是百分之百的神，也是百分之百的人。
And the Bible says in many passages that God the Father raised his son from the dead.
圣经中许多经节说到是父神使他的儿子从死里复活。
But it is also clear from scripture that Jesus had the power to raise himself from the dead.
可是从圣经我们也很清楚地看到耶稣他自己有大能可以使他自己从死里复活
thereby confirming his deity
如此便确认了他的神性
100% God and 100% man at the same time
百分之百的神百分之百的人在同样的时候
Jesus we see in John chapter 2 verse 19 Jesus answered them destroy this temple and I will raise it again in 3 days
约翰福音二章十九节，耶稣回答说：“你们拆毁这殿，我三日要再建立起来。”
Jesus was referring here to the temple of his body.
耶稣在这里讲到，用他的身体就是殿。
But the Jewish leaders misunderstood what he said as being the physical temple building.
但犹太的领袖呢，他们误会他所讲的是圣殿的这个建筑物。
In John 10:18, Jesus says, No one takes it from me, meaning his life. No one takes it from me, but I lay it down of my own accord. I have authority to lay it down and authority to take it up again. This command I receive from my Father.
约翰福音十章十八节，没有人夺我的命去，就夺去他的生命，是我自己舍的。我有权柄舍了，也有权柄取回来。这是我从父所受的命令。
From John 10:18, we see that Jesus himself has the authority or power to lay down his life as well as having the power to take it up again.
从约翰福音十章十八节我们看到耶稣他自己有权柄或者能力舍了他的命也有权柄有能力取回来。
In order, in meaning to raise himself from the dead.
就是使他自己从死里复活。
And only God has the power to give life.
只有神有能力赐下生命。
Only God can conquer or overcome death.
只有神才能够征服、战胜死亡。
So the resurrection confirms his deity.
所以，复活就确认了神他的神性。
That he is God come in the flesh.
他耶稣是神道成肉身来到。
Why did Jesus have to rise from the dead?
为何耶稣必要从死里复活
，in order to serve as the final judge，
作为最终的审判者。
You know, the first time that Jesus came to earth, as we were reminded on Friday night, he was mocked and despised.
耶稣第一次来到世上时候，我们在礼拜五的耶稣受难日的聚会里面，我们被提醒了，耶稣他被戏弄，被藐视。
He was a man of sorrows and familiar with suffering.
多受痛苦，常经忧患。
He was falsely accused.
他被人诬告。
Beaten.
鞭打。
Spit upon.
被吐唾沫。
He had a crown of thorns pushed into his head.
头被荆棘冠冕所压。
Nails driven into his hands and feet.
他的手和脚都被钉子钉入。
And a spear piercing his side.
肋旁被枪砸入
And he accepted all this.
他接受这一切。
Because the first time he came as the sacrificial lamb of God to die for our sins.
因为他第一次来到是被献上为祭的神的羔羊，为我们的罪受死。
And as a sheep before her shears is silent, so he did not open his mouth.
又像羊在剪毛的人手下无声，他也是这样不开口。
As Isaiah 53 verse 7 prophesied.
就如同以赛亚书五十三章七节所预言的。
That was the first time that he came to earth.
这是他第一次来到世上。
But the Bible says that one day he returns.
可是圣经告诉我们，有一天他会再来。
Not as the Lamb of God.
不是那时候不是神的羔羊。
But as the Lion of the tribe of Judah.
而是犹大支派中的狮子。
And he will be, as 1 Peter 4, 5 says, ready to judge.
就是他会如同彼得前书四章五节里面所说的，预备好了要行审判。
In 1 Peter chapter 4, verse 5, it says, but they will have to give account to him who is ready to judge the living and the dead.
彼得前书四章五节，他们必在那将要审判活人死人的主面前交账。
That means when he returns, he will judge those who are alive at that time, as well as those who have already died.
所以当基督再来的时候，他将要审判当时候活着的人以及已经死去的人。
This tells us that there is life after death.
这是告诉我们这在
life, there is life after death.
这告诉我们在死后我们有生命。
That this life on earth is not all that there is.
所以我们在世上，我们的生命不是就是如此而已。
That is why he will judge those who are dead.
所以他会审判那些死人。
In John chapter 5, verse 22, it says, Moreover, Jesus says, Moreover, the Father judges no one, but has entrusted all judgment to the Son.
约翰福音五章二十二节，父不审判什么人，乃将审判的事全交于子。
Jesus will return one day as the judge of all people.
有一天，耶稣将会再来，他成为审判所有人的审判者。
And this is why the Bible gives us the warning in Acts 17.
这是为什么在使徒行传十七章给了我们警告。
That because of the resurrection, there are no more excuses.
因为复活了，所以没有再有任何的借口了。
In Acts 17, verse 30 to 31, it says, In the past, God overlooked such ignorance, but now he commands all people everywhere to repent. For he has set a day when he will judge the world with justice by the man he has appointed. He has given proof of this to all men by raising him from the dead.
使徒行传十七章三十到三十一节，世人蒙昧无知的时候，神并不监察，如今却吩咐各处的人都要悔改，因为他已经定了日子，要借着他所设立的人按公义审判天下，并且叫他从死里复活，给万人做可信的凭据。
The resurrection of Christ is proof that there will be a final judgment, and that Jesus will be the one to carry it out.
所以圣经所告诉我们都是真理，所以说基督的复活是将来会有最终的审判，和耶稣就是那行审判的那一位的凭据。
In the future, he will be ready to judge.
在未来，他准备好了，他要行审判。
He will judge all those who have rejected him.
他会审判那些所有拒绝他的人。
And as a result, their sins are not forgiven.
结局就是他们的罪没有得到赦免。
And the result of that is eternal separation from God in hell.
结局就是永远的与神隔绝。
So in the future, he will be ready to judge.
在未来，他准备好了要行审判。
But now he is still ready to save.
但现在他仍然准备好了要行拯救。
At this time, he is still ready to forgive.
在这个时候，他准备好了，他要行赦免。
And if today you are not yet a believer,
如果今天你还不是一位信徒，
you must have your sins forgiven.
你的罪必须要得到赦免。
Or you will never be able to come into the presence of a holy God.
否则你就无法来到圣洁的神面前。
You will never be able to experience the relationship with a loving God.
你没办法经历与一位慈爱的神有个人的关系。
And if you have no assurance of eternal life in heaven.
你就没有在天堂有永生的确信。
And if you are still an unbeliever here today, you need to fear death.
如果你还不是一位信徒，你需要惧怕死亡。
Whenever that time may come,
无论什么时候，那个时候来到。
Perhaps years from now,
或许是几年以后。
Perhaps tomorrow,
或许明天。
Perhaps today,
或许今天。
But now is the time of grace.
现在是恩典的时候。
And grace is what really sets Christianity apart from all the world religions.
是恩典将基督教与世界其他的宗教区分开来。
Grace is what really makes it Christianity one of a kind rather than one of many.
是恩典使基督教独具一格，而不是众多宗教中的其中一个。
And now it is still.The time of grace.
现在仍然是恩典的时候。
In Christianity, it's not by any works that we can do to try to get to God, as every world religion tells you you have to do.
不像世界其他的宗教告诉我们要做的，要靠我们的行为到神那里去。
But in Christianity, it's whoever believes in Him, whoever believes in Jesus, will not perish but have eternal life.
可是基督教是所有相信耶稣的人就不自灭亡反得永生。
In Christianity, it is only by grace through faith in Jesus Christ.
所以基督教就是本乎恩信基督。
And not by any works that we can do.
而不是靠我们所做的行为。
And only Christianity has not only the resurrection,But only Christianity has grace, undeserved favor.
不仅只有基督教他们有复活，只有基督教他们有恩典，就是我们不配得到的恩惠。
And for the believer who has Christ,
信徒们，我们有基督。
There's no need to fear death.
就不需要怕死。
Because Jesus has overcome death.
因为基督已经战胜了死亡。
Because of the resurrection of Jesus.
因为耶稣的复活。
Death is now a springboard into the presence of the living God.
死就成了一个跳板，让我们可以进到神的面前。
Because our sins have been forgiven by Jesus.
因为我们的罪已经被耶稣赦免了。
And this is why Paul can say almost in a taunting way in 1 Corinthians 15:55.
所以这是为什么保罗几乎可以用一种嘲讽的方式在哥林多前书一章十五章五十五节说到。
Because Christ has been raised.
因为基督已经复活了。
Because Christ has conquered death.
因为基督已经战胜了死亡。
Where, O death, is your victory? Where, O death, is your sting?
死啊，你得胜的权势在哪里？死啊，你的毒钩在哪里？
I just want to give a reminder, though, to believers.
我想要给信徒们有一个提醒。
Jesus is not only the judge of the unbeliever.
耶稣他不仅审判非信徒。
He is also the judge of the believer.
他也会要审判信徒。
Not for judgment unto eternal damnation.
不是受审判进入永恒的咒诅中。
But judgment for rewards.
审判得赏赐。
The Bible says in 2 Corinthians chapter 5 that as believers we will all stand before the judgment seat of Christ.
保罗在哥林多后书第五章说我们所有的人都必要站在基督的审判台前。
And Jesus will test our works.
基督将会试验我们的工程。
How we have lived for him.
我们是如何的为他而活。
Not for our salvation.
不是为我们的救恩。
But for rewards.
而是为赏赐。
And as it has been said, when everything on earth has passed, only that which has been done for Christ,Will last.
当世上的一切都过去了以后，只有为基督所做的 所做的才会存留。
Four, why did Jesus have to rise from the dead?
为何基督必要从死里复活的第四个原因
？To assure us of our future resurrection.
是我们未来复活的确据。
I would encourage you, we will not read it today because of time. I would encourage you to, when you go home, to read 1 Thessalonians chapter 4, verses 13 to 18.
今天我们早上没有时间，但是我鼓励你们回家了以后，读帖撒罗尼迦前书四章十三到十八节。
As it tells us about the truth of the future resurrection of believers.
这告诉我们未来信徒的复活的真理。
In Jesus rising from the dead,
耶稣他从死里复活
He became the foundation and the assurance for our future bodily resurrection.
他成为我们未来身体得复活的根基与确据
This is where our spirit, the eternal aspect of man, will receive a glorified body like his.
就是我们的灵，就是我们里面永恒的那一层面，将会得到一个像他一样荣耀的身体。
Like his body after his resurrection.
像他复活以后的身体。
Philippians chapter 3 verse 21 assures us of this.
腓立比书三章二十一节给了我们这个确据。
That in the future, when we see Jesus.
在未来，当我们见耶稣的时候
，For those of us who are in Christ，
那些在基督里的人
，He will transform our lowly bodies so that they will be like His glorious body。
将我们卑贱的身体改变形状，和他自己荣耀的身体相似。
A body that is imperishable，
是一个不朽坏的身体。
A body that is immortal，
是不死的身体。
Fit for eternity in heaven。
适合在天堂的身体。
And this is why in 1 Corinthians chapter 15, verse 20.
这就是为什么在哥林多前书五十五章二十节所说。
Jesus is called the first fruits of those who have fallen asleep.
耶稣被称作是睡了之人初熟的果子。
Those who have fallen asleep is referring to those who have died in Christ and including those, all those who will later die in Christ.
那些在基督里已死去的人，包括那些那是以后在基督里死去的人。
In 1 Corinthians 15:20, it says, "But Christ has indeed been raised from the dead, the firstfruits of those who have fallen asleep."
哥林多前书十五章二十节，但基督已经从死里复活，成为睡了之人初熟的果子。
Before the harvest of a crop，
在农作物庄稼收成以前
，you have what is called the first fruits，
就会有初熟的果子。
This is a first indication of some fruit that indicates of that there is a great harvest that is to come。
这是确定将要来临的庄稼丰收的第一个征兆。
And the resurrection of Jesus is the first fruits.
耶稣的复活是初熟的果子。
The first indication of a great harvest in the future in the form of a bodily resurrection of all who have received him as Savior and Lord.
就是代表说是所有接受耶稣基督为救主和生命之主的人，未来身体得复活的凭据，是未来庄稼丰收的第一个征兆。
Of all who have died in Christ，
所有在基督里死的人。
But the Bible tells us that there are actually two future bodily resurrections of the dead。
但是圣经告诉我们，未来有两种身体的复活。
The first one is for those who have died in Christ, believing in Jesus as Savior and Lord.
第一种是那些在基督里死去的人，那些人他们有接受耶稣做他们的救主和生命的主。
And there will be a second type of bodily resurrection for those who have died without Christ.
是第二种身体的复活是对那些没有基督而死去的人。
Jesus tells us this in John chapter 5, verses 28 and 29.
耶稣在约翰福音五章二十八到二十九节告诉我们说
Jesus said, "Do not be amazed at this, for a time is coming when all who are in their graves will hear his voice and come out. Those who have done good will rise to live, and those who have done evil will rise to be condemned."
你们不要把这事看作稀奇，时候要到，凡在坟墓里的都要听见他的声音就出来，行善的复活得生，作恶的复活定罪。
Those who have done good is those who have done good by God's perfect standard.
行善的是需要按照神完美的标准。
And the only way that we're able to be good enough to meet God's perfect standard.
我们唯一我们可以达到神完美的标准行善的
is by receiving Jesus Christ so that all our sins are forgiven.
就是接受耶稣基督到我们的生命里，让我们的罪完全得到赦免。
And the goodness and the righteousness of Christ is upon us.
所以说神他的美善他的义都会给赐给我们。
So that as the Bible says, we are righteous, we are holy in his sight.
所以让我们在他的眼中，他看我们是美善的，是义的。
And all those who are good because of Christ, they will participate in the what is called the resurrection unto life.
所以这些行善的，就是接受耶稣的人，他们会复活得生。
But those who have done evil, which is all those who have not received Christ.
作恶的是讲那些没有接受耶稣基督的人。
They will be raised to be condemned and experience the resurrection unto judgment.
他们复活定罪是在耶稣的审判之下。
And the last reason that I want to give is to why did Christ have to rise from the dead?
最后我要给你们为何耶稣必要从死里复活的原因。
To assure us of our salvation in Christ.
是我们在基督里的救恩的确据。
In Romans chapter 4 verse 25 it says, He, meaning Jesus, was delivered over to death for our sins and was raised to life for our justification.
罗马书四章二十五节，耶稣被交给人是为我们的过犯，复活是为叫我们称义。
Justification is defined as the act of God by which He declares us righteous based on the finished work of Christ on the cross for our sins.
称义的定义是借着基督在十字架上为我们的罪所完成的工作，神称我们为义的，神的作为。
God declares us righteous, not because of anything that we have done.
神称我们为义，不是我们做的任何事。
But solely based on what Jesus has done for us.
完完全全取决在耶稣为我们所成就的。
And our justification involves having our sins forgiven.
我们的称义包括我们的罪完全得到赦免
and being given eternal life.
赐给我们永生。
We are justified by grace through faith in Christ alone.
我们被称义是本乎恩，因着单单的信基督。
And not by any works that we have done.
不是靠我们所做的任何行为。
In Romans 3:28, it says, For we maintain that a man is justified.By faith, apart from observing the law.
罗马书三章二十八节说，我们看定了人称义是因着信，不在乎遵行律法。
But the Bible also tells us that the resurrection is key to our justification.
可圣经也告诉我们，复活是我们称义的主要的理念。
1 Corinthians 15:17 tells us that without the resurrection, our faith is meaningless. Our sins are still unforgiven.
但哥林多前书十五章告诉我们，没有复活，我们的信是没有意义的，我们的罪仍然没有得到。
Paul says in 1 Corinthians 15:17, and if Christ has not been raised, your faith is futile. It is useless. You are still in your sins.
哥林多前书十五章十七节，基督若没有复活，你们的信便是徒然的，是没有用的，你们仍然在罪里，罪仍然没有得到赦免。
Why is this?
为什么呢？
A key reason is that if Christ was not raised from the dead,
一个主要的原因是，如果基督没有复活，从死里复活，
His death for us would merely be like one of the animal sacrifices in the Old Testament.
他的死不过像是旧约圣经里面的祭物一样，
only having limited value and effectiveness.
他的价值与效用都是有限的。
Hebrews chapter 10, verses 3 and 4 says, But those sacrifices, meaning all the sacrifices in the Old Testament, are an annual reminder of sins, because it is impossible for the blood of bulls and goats to take away sins.
希伯来书十章三到四节，但这些祭物就是讲到旧约圣经里面所讲的这些祭物，是叫人每年想起罪来，因为公牛和山羊的血断不能除罪。
All the animal sacrifices in the Old Testament, their blood being shed and them being killed, were only a temporary covering over for sin until you sin the next time.
所以在旧约圣经，所有这些祭牲的他的血，然后他们祭牲被杀，血流出来，也只是能够暂时的遮盖罪，只等到下一次你犯罪。
And then you need to make another sacrifice.
然后他们必须要再献上另外一个祭物。
But it would never take away sin.
但是没有办法把罪除去。
So the resurrection is God's way of setting the sacrifice of Christ apart from all the animal sacrifices in the Old Testament.
复活是神的方式，让基督为我们所做的牺牲与在旧约时代的献祭把它分别出来。
All the animal sacrifices in the Old Testament that were killed and they remained dead.
所以所有旧约的那些牲祭的祭物，它是死的，被杀了就死了。
The resurrection of Christ shows us that the sacrifice of Christ for us is an eternal sacrifice.
但是耶稣基督的复活让我们看到耶稣基督我们所做的牺牲是永远的牺牲。
And this is why God, Jesus had to be both God and man.
这是为什么耶稣必须又是神又是人。
So that he could be an eternal sacrifice.
他就可以成为那永远的牺牲。
That satisfies the eternal wrath of an eternal God against our sins.
满足永生神对我们的罪永远的愤怒。
The sacrifice of Christ, the blood that he sheds for us, that he shed for us, eternally purifies us from all sins.
耶稣基督他继续用他的血永远的洁净我们所有的罪。
And this is why there is no more need for animal sacrifices.
所以说这是不需要再献上任何祭牲。
They were all done to remind people that we are sinners and to point us to the ultimate sacrifice, eternal sacrifice, which is Jesus Christ.
提醒我们是要让我们的目光放在耶稣基督身上，那位永远的献祭身上。
So after hearing all this today,
我们今天听了这一切，
what are the implications for the unbeliever?
对非信徒的影响是什么呢？
Really only one.
只有一个。
Today, you must come before Jesus, admit that you're a sinner, and receive him into your life as your Savior and as your Lord.
今天你必须要来到耶稣的面前，接受耶稣到你的生命里面，做你的救主和你生命的主。
Whoever believes in him will not perish, but have eternal life.
叫切信他的不至灭亡，反得永生。
For the wages of sin is death.
罪的工价乃是死。
But the gift of God is eternal life in Christ Jesus our Lord.
唯有神的恩赐在我们基督耶稣里乃是永生。
What are the implications for the believer?
对信徒的影响是什么呢？
There are many.
很多。
I'll just mention a couple
before I close. 我只讲提这几个。
One is that we serve Brothers and sisters, a risen Savior.
弟兄姐妹，我们服侍的是个复活主。
who is now at the right hand of God the Father, who is interceding for us.
他现今坐在父的右边，替我们祈求。
Speaking to us, to the Father always, on our behalf.
为我们在到父的面前，为我们说话。
And he will come again and take us with him to the place where he has prepared for us.
他将会再来，要把我们带到他为我们所预备的地方去。
All according to the scriptures.
都是照圣经所说的。
And brothers and sisters, we need to be ready for his return.
弟兄姐妹们，我们必须在他的再来方面，我们要做好准备，预备好了。
May our Lord find us waiting and watching for him.
愿他看到我们是在等待他，密切地等候他。
And practically, this means faithfulness in our commitment to him and in our service to him.
实际上来说，就是在我们对他的奉献和服事上要忠心。
Another implication for the believer is that the power that raised Christ and that will raise believers in the future.
另外一个对信徒的影响就是，那是基督和未来信徒复活的大能。
Is the same power that can help us to live our daily Christian lives.
是同样的大能，能够帮助我们活出我们每日基督徒的生活。
Paul said in Philippians chapter 3 verse 10, he says, I want to know Christ and the power of his resurrection.
保罗在腓立比书三章十节说，是我认识基督，晓得他复活的大能。
I want to know the power of his resurrection, that I may live my life by his power.
保罗说，我要认识他复活的大能，让我们真的让他能够活出来这个大能在他生命当中。
For I know that I am weak, but he is strong.
我们知道我们是软弱的，但是他是刚强的。
And the word that is translated as power here in Philippians 3:10 is from the Greek word dunamis, from which we get the English word dynamite.
在腓立比书三章十节里面说的复活的大能，大能的那个原文的意思，翻译成现在的英文的话，就是炸药的意思。
And this power can help us to live our daily lives.
这个大能可以帮助我们在日常生活当中。
Peter also refers to this dunamis in 2 Peter chapter 1 verse 3.
在彼得也在彼得后书一章三节里面提到这个大能。
His divine power has given us everything we need for life and godliness through our knowledge of him who called us by his own glory and goodness.
神的神能已将一切关乎生命和前进的事赐给我们，皆因我们认识那用自己荣耀和美德召我们的主。
Brothers and sisters, we tend to take the power of God.In raising the dead and confine it just to the raising of Jesus.
弟兄姐妹们，我们常常通常呢，就将神复活的大能局限在耶稣基督的复活上。
But we don't often think that that power is available in our for our everyday lives.
但我们通常不认为这个大能可用在我们的日常生活当中。
So often we are living lives that are pitifully weak.
所以我们常常过着非常软弱可怜的生活。
And our attitude is more often, I can't, rather than by God's power, I can.
我们的态度常常是我做不到，而不是靠着神的大能我可以做。
And what is even more pitiful?
让我们更可怜的是
Often, our attitude is actually, I won't, or I don't want to.
而实际上我们的态度往往是我不愿意或我不想要做。
I won't forgive.
我不愿意饶恕。
I won't stop doing what I know is wrong.
我不愿意停止做我知道是不对的事。
I won't witness to others.
我不愿意向别的人做见证。
I won't try to get along with my parents.
我不愿意尝试和我父母亲好好的相处。
The list goes on.
很多很多其他的。
And that power is available to help us in our daily lives if we will but ask.
如果我们向神求，这大能是可以在我们日常生活中帮助我们的。
And that power that comes to us is not by our might or by our power, but by God's Spirit.
这个来到我们当中给我们的大能不是靠能力不是靠我们自己而是靠神的大能
And the more that we know Jesus,
我们越认识基督
the closer that we draw to Christ in our relationship with Him,
在我们与基督的关系之间我们与他更亲近的时候
the more we will be able to experience that power in our lives.
我们就越能够在我们生活中经历这大能
the more we will be able to experience that His grace is sufficient.
所以说保罗可以经历到的确他的恩典是够用的
And during those times as we come before Him in humility,
当我们谦卑地来到他的面前的时候
that His power is made perfect in our weakness.
他的大能就在我们的软弱上更显得完全
In closing,
最后结论
I want to look at a verse in 1 Corinthians chapter 15, verse 58.
所以我要看一个经节是哥林多前书15章58节
And the context of, God, of Paul's words here in 1 Corinthians 15 is actually in response to Jesus overcoming death and rising from the dead.
在哥林多前书15章58节是保罗看了上下文来看的话是保罗对耶稣战胜死亡的一个回应
And that, this is why Paul uses the word therefore.
所以在这个58节的最刚开始保罗就用这个字所以
Therefore, because Christ has overcome death.
因为基督已经战胜死亡所以
My dear brothers, stand firm. Let nothing move you.Always give yourself fully to the work of the Lord because you know that your labor in the Lord is not in vain.
我亲爱的弟兄们你们务要坚固不可摇动常常竭力多做主工因为知道你们的劳苦在主里面不是徒然的。
For the believer, because of the resurrection of Jesus.
对信徒来说因为基督的复活。
In our life, we can know that our struggles, our pains, our sorrows, even our service to the Lord are not in vain. They are not for nothing.
在我们生活中，我们知道我们的挣扎、我们的痛苦、我们的伤痛，甚至我们对主的服事，都不是徒然的，不是没有用的。
Jesus will give us the resurrection power.By way of the Holy Spirit to deal with them, so we will continue to persevere.
耶稣赐给了我们复活的大能，借着圣灵，他给我们这个大能，来帮助我们去面对这一切。因此，我们会继续坚持下去。
Also, our life is never meaningless.
而且，我们的生命从来都不是毫无意义的。
To those who don't have Jesus.Life really is meaningless.
对没不认识耶稣基督的人 they, 他们的生命实在是没有意义的
So many believe that once I die, I just close my eyes and everything is gone. That's it.
许多人想说哦我死了就是眼睛一闭一了百了了
But we know that that is not the case.
但是我们知道不是如此的
Because Jesus has risen from the dead.
因为耶稣已经从死里复活了。
Our life is never meaningless because we live for Him.
我们的生命不是没有意义的，因为我们是为他而活。
And because we know that life on earth is not final, we know that it is not all that there is.
因为我们知道我们在世的生命不是就此终结，生命不是就是一了百了了。
Because He lives.
因为他活着。
We who believe will live with Him forever in heaven.
我们所有相信他的人会永远在天上与他同活。
Our hope for the present and for the future is anchored in the person of Jesus Christ.
我们对目前和未来的盼望是寄托在那耶稣基督身上。
Our living Savior and Lord.
我们永活的救主和生命的主。
Let's pray.
我们一起祷告。
Our dear Lord Jesus, as we reflect on your resurrection.
亲爱的主耶稣，我们思想到你的复活。
Lord Jesus, we're reminded again that all that you have done, that you have done for us.
让我们思想到所有你为我们成就的这一切。
All that you have done is for our good.
你所成就的这一切都是为了我们的好处。
It is not to harm us, but to help us.
不是要伤害我们，是要帮助我们。
Not only in your death and sacrifice for us on the cross for our sins,
不仅在十字架上为我们的罪的受苦、牺牲、受死。
But Lord, also your resurrection from the dead is for us.
你从死里复活也是为了我们。
You are preparing a place for us.
你为我们预备好了地方。
You are interceding for us.
你为我们得到这一切。
You are interceding for us.
你为我们祈求。
Lord Jesus, everything that you in this present life, you are always with us.
在我们在世的时候，你总是与我们同在。
Lord Jesus, help us to grow in our love for you.
主耶稣，真是帮助我们。让我们爱你更多。
Help us to grow closer to you.
让我们与你更亲近。
Help us to know you more and more.
让我们更多的认识你。
And Father, in Jesus, I pray especially for those here today, whether in person or online, who do not yet know you.
特别是为今天实体在这里聚会或晚上聚会，为那些还不认识你的人。
That you would open their spiritual eyes by your Holy Spirit through your word, that they would see that you, your purpose is not to harm them, but to help them.
用你的圣灵，真是开，用你的话语开了他们属灵的眼睛，看到主，你实在不是要伤害他们，你是要帮助他们的。
That it is foolish to reject you.
要，如果要拒绝你，实在是很愚昧的。
And that it is wise to receive you.
可是接受你的是有智慧的。
We thank you, Lord, for all that you have done.
我们谢谢你为我们所成就的这一切。
We thank you, Lord, for all that you are.
我们为你的一所有的都，我们为此我们感谢你。
May you receive all the glory and honor and praise that you deserve in our lives and in your church.
这是在我们的身上，在我们教会里，愿你得到你配得的所有的尊贵荣耀。
In Jesus' name we pray.
奉主耶稣基督名祷告。
Amen.
Amen.
Thank you, Pastor Elton, for the message.
谢谢朱牧海布依涵牧师的信息。
For sharing the five reasons why Jesus need to rise from the dead.
跟我们分享耶稣必要从死里复活的五个原因。
And this gave us the confidence and the assurance of our faith and our salvation.
也是对我们的救恩的一个确信。
I'd like to welcome.Everyone here today. I'd like to welcome everyone here today.
欢迎在座的每一位。
Do we have any newcomer?
在我们当中有新来的吗？
I'd like to welcome the persons on this side.
Okay, 在我们右手边，请自我介绍。
Can we have the mic ready?Hold one second so that we can hear you. Please power the handheld mic on.
给我们一点时间把那个麦克风把它打。
Would you stand up and introduce yourself?
Hello, my name is Isabel Jimenez, and I am a newcomer. Thank you.
Thank you.
Isabel,
That's her name.
Isabel.
She's okay. The first time.
Is there any more on my right side? Would you please stand and introduce yourself?
I speak Chinese. Okay.
请大家再自我介绍。我叫蔡仁义，是来自中国上海。好，欢迎。
Oh, okay. Any more on this side?
还有没有在我们右手边的？
If not, we will welcome the newcomer on my left side.
我们欢迎在我们左手边的新来的，请问有没有新来的
？Okay. We will take a couple of minutes to go over the announcement.
我们花几分钟来看报告事项。
The spring retreat will be held on Memorial Day weekend, May 27 to 29 at Biola.
我们的春令退休会将在 Biola 大学在国商节的周末5月27号到29号举行。
The speaker is Elder Jackson Randall.
我们讲员是 Jackson Randall 长老。
You can sign up online or in person.
OK, 你们可以实体的方式报名或者是到教会的网站报名。
So the registration deadline is next Sunday.
报名的截止日期是下个主日。
The next several announcement is concerning the three elder sisters that has been with the Lord.
接下来的报告事项是由三位年长的姐妹们过世。
It is sad, but we are tempered by the fact that this will be just a short separations.
就是我们知道，虽然他们离去，只是暂时的跟他们分开。
The first is Brother Jack Ng's mother.
第一位是吴永清弟兄的母亲。
She passed away on the 25th of last month.
是王唐仁秀姐妹，她是上个月25号安息主怀。
Her memorial service will be held at 2 p.m. on 4:20.
是4月20号下午2点有追思礼拜。
The service will be held in Memorial Chapel in Rose Hill.
是在玫瑰山的他的Memorial Chapel 里面，玫瑰港的 Memorial Chapel 举行。
The next sister is what I have been calling her, 雷婆婆。She went to be with the Lord on 4/2 at 4:30 a.m.
另外是李好老姐妹，她是4月2号凌晨4点半。
Her memorial service will be held at 11 a.m. on 4/18.
她的追思礼拜将于4月18号上午11点举行。
The next sister is Grace Chow.
另外一位是张彩珠老姐妹。
She went to be with the Lord on 3/31.
她在3月31日过世。
Please remember all their families.
请在祷告中纪念这些家人们。
And everyone is welcome to stay for lunch.
我们也欢迎你们留下来享用午餐。
Let's rise and sing the doxology.
让我们起立唱三一颂。
Let's pray.
我们一起的。
Dearly Father, we thank you for the service that you provide us here today.
亲爱的天父，我们为今天你所赐给我们这个崇拜聚会，我们感谢你。
May our heart be pleasing and acceptable to you. May our worshipful heart be accepted and pleasing to you.
愿我们对你的敬拜蒙你受接纳，而且蒙你喜悦。
May your forever presence in our daily walk help us to follow you closer.
让我们每一天真的是经历到你的同在，让我们紧紧的每一天跟随你。
Give us grace to live a life that will be pleasing to you.
赐给我们恩典，让我们活出讨你喜悦的生活。
In Jesus' name, pray. Amen.
奉主耶稣基督名祷告，阿门。
Please be seated. This concludes our worship today.
请坐，默祷，散会。